YouTube team, keep it clean. What's going on? It's Saint Graven here with another video and another episode of NFL Questions from Subscribers. This is a series where you can ask me any NFL question you want to based off of any NFL team, and we answer it in a video just like this. If you want to be part of NFL Questions from Subscribers, then send me an email to teamkeepitclean@gmail.com, or if you're a patron, you can send it directly on Patreon. Love y'all, team. Keep it clean. I appreciate y'all. It is Monday, May 10th, so it's a new week, the start of a new week. It is 8:36 a.m., and I went to sleep early last night, so I feel refreshed, and I never go to sleep early. Like, I went to sleep around, like, 10 o'clock. That's very, very early for me, because usually it's, like, 12, 1, sometimes 2, but around then. But I went to sleep around 10, and I feel like, I love y'all, team. Keep it clean. I appreciate y'all. We got some great questions like we always do. Shout out to all the Team Keep It Clean patrons. Appreciate y'all coming through. And Team Keep It Clean as a whole, man, this is going to be a fun week. And things going to keep rolling. Even though the NFL is about to slow down quite a bit, things still going to be rolling over here. So I love y'all. I appreciate y'all being a part of this thing, man. And let's do it. So the first question on this episode of NFL Questions from Subscribers came from me to y'all. And the Ravens, I got to give them credit. I got to start off by giving them credit because their plan, whatever their plan for him, if they still even have a plan for him, so far it's worked out even better than they could have imagined. Because I was somebody, y'all know, I was somebody, and I still am somebody that's against it. But like I said before, if it worked out for the Ravens, I will still give them their credit. But I was somebody that was definitely against the whole comp pick thing, like them saving the comp picks if a good player is available that can really help their team. And I know they want to save the comp picks, but I would just be like, nah, if somebody's available, and I still feel this way, but if somebody good is available and they may possibly have other interests, go get them. Don't even take that risk because things could change. Unfortunately, injuries happen. Like with the Broncos, the offensive lineman, that could have been Villanueva, but it ended up, I believe, being Dennis Kelly. But things could change very fast. But I was somebody that with Justin Houston, I'm like, man, they should get this guy now. But the Ravens were like, no, comp pick formula. No, we don't want him to count against the comp pick formula. But the draft came and went. May 3rd came and went. It's in fact, it's been a week after May 3rd. So that came and went. So that has actually put the Ravens in position to have even more leverage if they're still interested in him, even more leverage over Justin Houston, because it's like, hey, you ain't counting against the comp pick formula. Ain't nobody signed you yet. You're still out there. You're still a free agent. So that sort of lowers his value. And I mean, well, I know I can't even say that 100% because I thought that Alejandro Villanueva, I thought that he was going to sign for like maybe like a 1 year, $5 or $6 million deal. And it was 2 years, $14 million. Not only 1 year is guaranteed, so it's essentially a 1 year, $8 million deal. But still, when I saw that, I was like, whoa, oh, okay. I did not expect him to get that much. But with Justin Houston being another week removed from the whole comp pick formula, and he's still out there. We haven't heard anything about Justin Houston whatsoever. Nothing. So we're still waiting, still wondering, still watching, hoping, something. So should the Ravens still make that move? They drafted Odafe away. They, of course, still have Pernell McPhee, Sack Daddy, Jalen Ferguson. And of course, they re-signed Tyus Bowser as well. So should they still get him? I think it's a no-brainer. I think, of course, they should. The Ravens have, they started off this offseason. I know a lot of Ravens fans, I mean, it happens literally every single year. Y'all know the Ravens fans that freak out. Like, oh, man, Ravens aren't doing anything. This is terrible. Man, whoever the GM is at the time, they would do it under Ozzie. They would do it under Eric DeCosta. Be, oh, man, he's terrible. He's this, he's that. Oh, he's terrible. He needs to get fired. Da, 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 da. And a lot of Ravens fans would do that if the Ravens didn't make a move on the first, second, or even third day of free agency. They'd freak out. But I can honestly say, man, and y'all know me, I call it how it is, man. I don't like somebody the other day, I forgot who it was. Somebody was like, I question your heart as a Ravens fan if you're already saying that you don't expect them to make the Super Bowl. And I was like, what? Anyway, but I call it how I see it. And like I said, I hope they make the Super Bowl. I really do. But for me, I got to see in order to believe. Because you can get all these different players here and there, but you got to scheme those players. You got to fit those players into your scheme, and you got to have them involved. More so on offense. That's the biggest question mark. How much are the Ravens going to involve these different guys on offense? Because you could have the best of the best. But if you don't get them involved, then, hey, it's not going to mean much. So hopefully this year with the Ravens is a curve. It's a curve with the involvement of their wide receivers. And it's been talked about several times that with the Ravens in this offense, how they you see the positions that really exceed and the positions that really develop. See the running backs? Oh, yeah, they develop like crazy. Like, man, these guys, over the course of a year, you see them the change, you see the improvement. It's like, wow, whoa, how about that? But then at the wide receiver position, it's the exact opposite. It's the exact opposite. Because we, of course, saw the improvement with Hollywood, but he was like the only receiver that was really consistently involved in the games. So, and there were even some games where he wasn't involved like that. But we saw his improvement over time, but for mostly everybody else, no. Nah. So for me, seeing is believing. That's why right now I said Ravens AFC Championship. Because the question was, what do you consider a successful season for the Baltimore Ravens? But back to what my original point was that this after the draft, after free agency, and where we are right now at this point of the offseason, I feel like the Ravens are very, very close to actually being a complete team. Very, very close. And you know they're still going to make a couple moves here and there. But I feel like having that quality veteran presence, and then again, that Pernell McPhee, but that quality veteran presence that is a good producer, that has been a good producer at the pass rush position. If they brought in Justin Houston, then I feel like that would definitely help take them to another level. I really do. So for me, I think it's a no-brainer that they should sign him. They have money available to sign him. And they still, of course, got to sign all their draft picks and stuff. But they got enough bread to sign him. They can get something done. Probably a one-year deal. A one year, $4 to $5 million deal. I say 4.5 guaranteed and another 1.5 available to get through incentives. So a one-year $6 million deal. But yeah, I think they should definitely get it done. I think they should because they've built up the offensive line. And it's like they've built up the offensive line and they have depth. They have depth on the offensive line. So they got Tyree Phillips right now as a backup. Patrick McCarry right now, he's a backup. And it's like whether it's Ben Powers being a backup, Ben Cleveland being a backup. Oh, well, we got to see him on the NFL level first because I can't call him a quality backup yet because we haven't seen him on the NFL level first. And he might end up being a starter. But the Ravens, of course, at the wide receiver position, not everybody's going to be able to make it. Bateman, Locke, Hollywood, Locke, Tylan Wallace, Locke, Sammy Watkins, Locke, Devin Duvernay, Locke, and Miles Boykin. I think that he'll make it. There's a lot of pressure on him, but I think that he'll make it. Cause I was talking to one of my guys, you know who you are, but Miles Boykin, he's the only guy that's he's 6'4". He's 6'4", and he's the best blocker on the team, best blocker receiver on the team. So I think Ravens will be hard pressed to let Miles Boykin go. But we'll see. You just never know, man. You never know. But they've done a lot at the wide receiver position. Obviously, quarterback is fine. But running back, that's fine. Defensive line, they kept all their guys intact, brought back Derek Wolfe. So they got all the same guys that they're rocking with. Their linebackers, Patrick Queen, and somebody made a really good point, I forgot who it was, about how with Odafe away, Patrick Queen is already flying around. He's already flying around. But then you pair that speed, his speed, with Odafe away's speed. It's like, ooh, man, these guys, they're all over the field. So then, of course, Malik Harrison, they brought back LJ Fort, which when they cut him, a lot of us were sad and upset. I did not like the move at all. But then the Ravens were like, hold up, wait, chill, y'all just vibe, man. We bringing them back. Don't even worry about it. So they brought him back, and I was like, okay, great. Secondary. They already had a really good secondary, but now after the draft, Brandon Stevens, and then Wade as well, So they did that as well. So they added depth. They had a really good secondary, but they added depth. So they should be getting Tay-Tay back. Hopefully he can be healthy this entire year this year. Now as safety is the only position where it's like, because right, you got your starters. You got Deshaun Elliott, you got Chuck Clark, you got those guys. But then behind them, you got Anthony Levine, you got Jordan Richards. So you're safe at safety, but you got to think that, I mean, I know Brandon Stevens, that he's supposed to be a guy that they say they want to play safety, that they want him to play free safety or whatnot. So we'll see. So you got your guys that are there, but I could see them making another move there, possibly. Oh, yeah, and they've got Geno Stone as well. So they got some young depth there. They got some young depth, experienced depth too with Levine. Was it my guy Cam Neal? I think it was Cam, but I forgot who it was. Somebody was like, with Brandon Stevens, just imagine a guy who used to play offense because he used to be a running back. Just imagine a guy who used to play offense. So he got experience playing offense, and he has experience playing corner. Imagine him being a safety / corner or whatnot, especially with the experience that he has on offense. So his understanding of an offense that can help him at the safety position. So that's something, too. And then, of course, your kicker, your punter, they said your long snapper now is different. Nick Moore, we're going to see how that works itself out. I think it should be fine, though. But anyway, my point is the Ravens, they have a pretty complete team. When you really go up and down the roster and you really think about that entire roster, they have a complete team. They have a team that's like ready right here, right now. Let's do it. Even though they had that for the past like 2 years, especially last year. But now I feel like it's even more complete than last year. And I'm not just saying that because I'm a Ravens fan. I'm not just saying that because, I'm on this high after the draft and after free agency and no. I'm saying that realistically. The team is they're pretty complete. But you added Justin Houston to that veteran presence at the pass rush position. I think it would be a really good move. And I think it's something that they should definitely do. For sure. It would be great, man. It would be great. And I know a lot of Ravens fans, some Ravens fans forgot now. But a lot, I'll be seeing y'all in the comment section. A lot of Ravens fans did not forget. They did not forget. And there's still Ryan Kerrigan out there, too. He's another option. There's still Melvin Ingram out there. He's another option. But my preference, if I had to go in order, Justin Houston would be first. And then between Kerrigan and Ingram, Ingram, I'm biased to him because of the last name, of course. Are we cousins? Hey, who knows? But I mean, he ain't sent no money my way anyway, so it really don't matter. But between Kerrigan and Ingram, who would I give the edge to? Really, either one. After Houston, it's like a toss up for me, honestly. So yeah, man. But Houston, I think they should still make that move and add to this already complete team, make them even more complete. Team Keep It Clean, I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. Y'all are a very complete team to me in my eyes, and I appreciate everything that you all do for each other. Thank you for continuing to build each other up. Thank you for continuing to spread positivity to each other, and thank you for continuing to spread love, because everybody needs it, especially with how stuff is these days. I love y'all, appreciate y'all, and we out.